gotta take the dirt real quick.
I should be embarrassed, but I'm not.
Welcome to the show. My name is Dallas Poli. I'm the director of Hairspray. I'm also a professor of humanities and theater here at EMUR. And what we call this is the curtain speech. And I forgot my handy dandy little written out speech thing that I usually have because the production staff doesn't trust me. So the way I figured, it's the last show. So if I miss it, who cares? So we'll get it right next week. So what we do during the curtain speech is I tell you a little bit about what we expect from you, what you can expect from us during the show, as well as what you can see or hope to see during the show. You can turn it off. Yeah, I'm looking at this. We're actually, there's seats around everyone, but we are at a sold out show. All of our tickets are gone. So at some point there should be people coming in and trying to sit by you, hopefully. But if not, no refunds. So, I just feel like I can be honest with you guys. Nonetheless, so what's going on? We will be observing a 10-minute intermission during this production, and so the lights will come up, and you guys can go out to the lobby. However, we understand because of the size of the audience that the bathroom issue can kind of get a line going, so the building right outside the doors over here is the ITC building, and those doors will be open so that you can use the restrooms over there as well. And that way we can still maintain our 10-minute intermission. You guys can get back in a timely fashion. We will also be utilizing hairspray, thus the show, during this production. And it lets off a nice little fog that goes around the room, and it looks pretty cool. But I just want everybody to know that it's not actually hairspray or aerosol of any kind. It's water vapor. And the reason I say that is because anytime we spray anything or any smoke comes off stage, the audience tends to automatically start going, coughing. But just that board, too. Acting. So we always want to let you know that it's just water. So if somebody's sitting next to you and they start coughing after that, just turn to them and just go, it's water. And I always ask to do loud so all of us can go, that guy. In the fall, it will be Dan Loco, my colleague, who has done a lot of wonderful shows here. He will be doing a fairy tale Christmas carol. And we just wanted to make sure everybody checks out. We're going to have a website going up this summer and stay up to date. She's on that to see what's going on. Also, during the show, we'll be utilizing the stairs. So we're going to be going up and down. The cast will be going up and down, up the stairs, off the stage, and into the audience. Because we like to make you part of the show. But so what we ask is when, if you were sitting down here close to the audience, that move your feet and your bags, everything up, feet and bags, off the stairs. That way my actors don't actually literally break a leg. They can get back up on the stage. So if you have anything in the aisles, please make sure they're clear, such as bags or children or whatever. So underneath the chair. If you have a small one with you, as you can tell, I can't sit still for 15 minutes. For 15 seconds. If you have a small one, it's a 2-hour show, we understand they may be a little unruly during the show. So what we ask is to keep the illusion of theater going and not to disturb the people around you. Then you go ahead and take your small one and go up to the lobby. We have a nice lobby that can run around in there, and then we'll hold the door for you guys to come right back in here. More importantly, there is also no cameras allowed. There's no picture taking, no videoing. I'm sure everyone's like, there's a video camera. I have the right to do that, you're not. So we will be videotaping today. Don't get any ideas, okay. But we would really appreciate for everybody here to keep their cameras and or what they deem not to be a camera, their cell phones. Let's go ahead and take a minute to all check our cell phones, now that I have my cell phone out. Where are you at, Matt? My drummer was just telling me he's going to text me. Nothing. Check it. Nonetheless, I know you say that this is a phone, not a camera, but if we see your phone out, we're pretty much thinking that either you're taking a photo with it, or you're talking on it, or you're texting on it. And what we ask is that for all of you to go ahead and silence your phone, because we want to keep the aesthetic distance alive as well. And we ask you to refrain from texting, because the light from your phone can be distracting to the actors, as well as to everybody else around you, and it's rude to do that. It's so sad, it's my last night to shame the audience. Okay. But yes, put your phone away. If you see your phone out, you'll have a nice, scary young man come and tap you on the shoulder and say, "Can you please put your phone away?" And if that young man has to come back and tap you on the shoulder again, it's more, "Can you please leave?" Because we care more about the people on the shoulder. you around even when you go back and text messages. So please be aware of that. And also, because I know you want to take photos of your loved ones and people in the show, I invite you at the end of the show to come up onto the stage, and the actors will be up here. My cast is too large to go out to the lobby, so they'll be up here, and at the very end, you come up here and take pictures of the set, take pictures of the actors. We have posters on sale. If you want them to sign them, you can grab some of those and come up here. So you're more than welcome to do so. And I'm hurrying because we had to do our last speech today. Now, every night, last night, we actually got to do something very fun and cool that Daniel and I have been planning for years and years, 7 years. Actually, and we built this theater literally on a $25 investment. I don't know who's $25, we'll figure that out later. But now that we're self-sufficient, and we couldn't do that without all of you guys coming to our shows, we were able to actually start having awards, and we were able to give out our first award, a Rising Star Award, to Dominic Batista last night because, well, look at the kid, right? Yeah, so he was our first recipient, and now we'll be able to get that yearly. But I would also like to take the time, because I've been asking, thanking all my production staff, and it's really interesting for you guys to come in and see your theater without actually knowing the amount of work that goes into the theater. I like to say that it's not Charlie Brown. It's not like we get together on a Friday and say, let's put on a show. I mean, anybody can sing a song, but can you sing for 2 hours straight on your feet and dance nonstop through the whole thing without losing your breath and your pitch? Yeah, I know, right? So we do a lot of conditioning. We really couldn't have done a lot of the singing that you're going to hear tonight without Crystal Jeffers Polon, who I know personally. Crystal is my wife, and she is the band director as well as the music director for the musical. And it's funny because I get so much credit for the musicals that I do, and I don't teach them the singing. That's not my thing. That's her thing. And I honestly, the amount of talent that we have on this stage went from 100 to 210% because of Crystal. The amount of work she put in to stretch their voices, to get them to sing out, to get them to hit those ranges is just absolutely mind-boggling. And besides just being an awesome person and wife, she's just an amazing music director. So at the end of the show, if you get to see Crystal and you really enjoy the singing, please, please go up to her and say thank you. Thank you for all of your hard work.
Thank you. hard to bear corny problems.
Delinquent! It ain't right to that color music.
Don't be silly. It ain't color. The team is black and white.
Brenda?
9 months.
So, it's
your mother she wants you.
She does? I better hurry. Bye, Mrs. Turnblad. Bye, Tracy.
Whoa, rush hour traffic. Hiya, ladies. Since I got my new shipment of exploding bubblegum, business downstairs is booming. How about you, funny ladies?
Oh, stop, Wilbur. You're the funny one.
Daddy, tomorrow I'm auditioning to dance on a TV show.
You'll have to go farther than that to get around me, young lady. No one is auditioning for anything. And what have I told you about that hair? All ratted up like a teenage Jezebel?
Mother, you are so 50s. Even our first lady, Jackie Lee Kennedy, rats her hair.
Oh, yeah? Well, you ain't no first lady, are you? She's a hair hopper. That's what she is. And you gotta put in detention again. Wilbur, talk with her. Girls like Tracy, people like us, they don't put people like us on television except to be laughed at.
Tracy, this TV thing, you really want it?
It's my dream, Daddy.
Then you go for it, babe. This is America. You gotta think big to be big.
Being big is not the problem, Wilbur.
When I was your age, my parents begged me to run away with the circus. I said no, that's what you want. I had dreams of my own. I dreamt of opening up a chain of joke shop worldwide. So okay, I've only got the one, but as soon as I can figure out how to stop the air from leaking out of my self-sized whooping cushion, I'm gonna make a noise around the world! You follow your dream, baby. I'm grabbing an orange crush and headed back down to the Hardy Horror Hut. I got my dream and I won it!
You're not helping, Wilbur.
Thanks, Daddy.
Tracy, get back up here. I have a hamper of laundry and my diet pill's wearing off.
But Mama, I wanna be famous!
You wanna be famous? Learn to get blood out of car upholstery. Now that's a skill you can take right to the bank. You think I want to spend my life washing and ironing other people's clothing? No, I wanted to design them. I thought I would be the biggest thing in brassieres. Better watch what you wish for.
But all I was doing was watching Corny Collins over at Tracy's.
Didn't I forbid you from listening to that race music? Oh, if the police ever locate your father, he'll punish you good.
Amber, your dancing was just atrocious today. I'll do anything, lie, cheat, and steal to get you that Miss Hairspray crown, but girl, you've got to work with me. Now, let me add that zit.
Stop! That's no way to treat clean clothes. One day you own Edna's outfit in the laundry. Will you be ready?
I hope not. Don't contradict me.
Don't disobey me.
Don't even think about going to that audition.
Please?
No! No.
No.
too much. Tracy, look! It's Link! Link Larkin! So near and yet so gorgeous!
I know, I mean, those girls were all over me. You know, I don't know how Rock Hudson stands it.
Right.
Oh, excuse me, little darling. I hope I didn't dent you too.
I can hear them.
Tracy, are you alright?
Well, don't you hear them chime?
I don't hear anything.
He looked at me and stared at me. Mom.
is it? And may I be frank? First impressions can be tough. When I saw you, I knew it. If your size weren't enough, then that answer just blew it. And so, my dear, so big and stout, you'll never be in. So we're kicking you out. You can't get past me, kid. But it isn't your fault. It's hard to get rid of this floating heart crap. Oh, here we go. Thank you. I think they secretly liked you. Hello, ma'am. May I please audition? No. But you may bow and exhaust, for I am Miss Goldfinger
we say hit it, show me a big band. Baltimore Bucks. Hit it!
Tracy Turnblad, call down up to Corny and tell us about yourself. Therese?
Well, I go to Patterson Park High, I watch your show, and I do absolutely nothing else. But someday I hope to be the first female president of the world, or a rocket. You gotta think big to be big.
And if you were president, what would your first official act be?
Well, I'd make every day Negro Day.
What do you say, kids? Sounds like we have a hot new candidate for Miss Teenage Hairspray.
No, she can't be Miss Hairspray. She's the before in the Metrical Diet ad. And I'm the after. And actors always win.
Amber! What a comedian! So, Trace, tell us true. How would you like Link Larkin to sing a song just for you?
No, he can't! Because everyone knows that whenever he sings to me. He's completely involved with me.
Right! So, Trace, tell us true. How would you like Link Larkin to sing a song just for you?
Would I? People are completely ignoring the laws of nature!
Link Larkin, our own budding Elvis, will now sing to the equally glowing Tracy Turnblad his version of this week's Top 40 hit, It Takes Two.
No!
Oh!
Oh!
I can assure you,
chubbiest girls buy hairspray too, Mr. Spritzer.
Mrs. Von Trussell, what do you plan to do with this?
I plan to start by firing him.
You can't fire Corny Collins from the Corny Collins Show.
Why not? They do it all the time on Lassie.
Mr. Spritzer, if you want to keep your audience, you gotta keep up with the times.
The show is just fine the way it is.
Bringing Tracy on the show is just the beginning. I have terrific ideas for updating the show.
I'm getting one of my sick headaches. Is there a place I might lie down?
I have a bed in my office.
Change that too.
Collins, are you threatening me?
Oh, Velma, you know me. On the other hand, I could always take the show to Channel 11.
Oh my God, the snake that sings. He's a puppet, but I hold the purse of the God, I knew Negro Day would bring chaos and change. Now he's pushing this Negro who might give us all change. She's a blemish, a blackhead that must be expelled. She's a standard of beauty that must be withheld. You can say I'm a bigot, but it just isn't true, see? I love Sammy Davis and he's black attitude.
Hello? Yes! I'm sure Tracy appreciates your vote for this teenage hairspray. Yes! And she loves you too, very much. Whoever you are. Goodbye. This is crazy. Hello? What am I wearing? A house dress, flats, and sock holes. What are you wearing? Hello? Hello? To think, a beloved TV icon, the fruit of my womb.
So you're not mad?
Mad? How can I be mad? You're famous. But if I'd only known you was going to get on the show, I wouldn't have told you that you couldn't. But tell me, is fame everything you thought it would be? Are you happy, honey?
Yes, Mama. And I think I'm in love.
I know. I've been following. But you and I are going to have a talk about crooners. One can learn a lot from the mistakes of Miss Debbie Reynolds. There it goes again.
Hello? Yes, this is Tracy Turnblad. Hello, Mr. Pinky?
Mr. Pinky? The Mr. Pinky? As in Mr. Pinky's hefty hideaway? Quality clothes for quantity gals? That Mr. Pinky?
You want to hire me as your exclusive spokesgirl and fashion effigy? What's an effigy? That's very flattering, but I'm afraid all business must go through my agent. Oh, it would be our pleasure, Mr. Pinky. We'll be right over. Goodbye.
Agent? I don't know any agents. How about a nice bail bondsman?
Mother, I'm taking my new agent to the Hefty Hideaway and out on the town.
Tracy Turnblad, has fame gone to your brain and left you wacky? You need a top shelf professional. Who handled the Gabor sisters? Well, who didn't?
Mama, there's a great big world out there I know nothing about. When things get tough, a girl needs her mother.
Hun, is that what you- one, I'll be right beside you. And together, we'll fly your way to the top. But can't we do it over the phone? I haven't been out of your apartment since maybe I can have Bob your bags and roll your hose.
Come
ball.
Yeah! A what?
Kathy Schmink told me. She heard Tracy was in the back seat of the car with two boys at once. Playing tonsil hockey. In the noon.
Is it true they put her in special ed?
Yep. Tracy turned black is a tramp. And she's retarded. That's right. She's fast and slow at the same time. Lee Martin, how did you kiss that beehive buffalo right on the air?
Oh, come on, Amber. That didn't mean anything. It was, I don't know, just a cool way to end the song.
Hey, look, here they come, special ed!
Don't knock it off, man. That ain't cool, man. Try to act like a grown-up.
Special ed, huh?
Special!
Raven Clark, if fate forces you to throw the ball at me today, seal it with a kiss.
You got a parent there for me, too? This game can get pretty vicious.
What is scatter dodgeball, anyway?
It's kind of like a protest rally. When the cops show up, you better scatter and dodge.
Hi, Tracy. Sorry about your special edness, but think of it as a testament to the record-breaking extremes your hair has reached. I'm so jealous.
Hello? Oh, Stevie, this is my best friend, Henny Lou Pingleton.
Now, wait, we've met before, right? At the gum machine. You were getting a pack of Wrigley's.
I did 2 packs a day.
All that chewing must make the muscles of your mouth mighty strong.
Not really. Probably just average.
Well, 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 Tracy Tugboat, wah, wah. You finally found the title you could win, Miss Special Ed.
Knock it off, Amber.
Amber Von Tessel, you had acne of the soul.
I can't see why people don't be seen to come around my face.
They have a sparkin', Sir Lane Larkin.
Always nice to see you, Miss Motormouth.
And I'm Penny Lou Pinkleton, and I'm very pleased and scared to be here.
Come in, kitten. It's okay to sit in.
This is just so apropos-tastic. Can I say how thrilled I am to meet you? I'm Seaweed's friend, Tracy.
Yes, indeedy. I've seen you, sweetie. All aglow on the Corny Collins show.
Gee, thanks. The only reason I'm on the show is because of your son. Why can't we all get together like this on TV?
Think we haven't tried? We pleaded, begged, and lied. We pressured the mayor, we petitioned the gov, and what do we get?
One day a month.
That's enough talking, y'all. We came here to dance. Let's play hide and seek.
The dream monkey.
That came out wrong. I've been singing and dancing and smiling on the show for 3 years, waiting for it to lead to my break. You've got everything. Brains, talent, personality. Me, I've got one chance to get seen nationwide. Tracy, Saturday night's everything I've worked for. I'm not gonna throw it away. Now come on, I'm going, you gotta come with me.
No, I want to do this, and so should you. It's what's right. Link, stay, please.
Sorry.
But you and me together, I was just starting to think—
Sure. I know, me too. But it's getting too complicated. And there's still Anna. See you later, Laura.
I'm sorry, Tracy. Oh, Mama. How could I ever think Link Larkin could care for someone like me?
Why wouldn't he? You're a lovely girl. He's just Eddie Fisher all over again.
Mama, don't tease. I really like him. I've never felt anything like this before.
I know. And he probably likes you too. It's just, boys aren't the brightest things. Still, give him time. I'm sure he'll realize that he's crazy about you.
You have to say that. You're my mother.
I'm more than your mother. I'm a woman in love who knows about this kind of stuff.
But Tracy, he could be Ray. Should you risk your career?
I never even would have gotten on the show if it weren't for Stevie. No, it's payback time.
That's my girl.
So this is how we're gonna do it. Tomorrow, everyone bring your mothers
and sisters
and meet around the corner from the studio and make signs.
Yes, and put words on them.
You and little Inez walk in first. Me and Mama will be right behind you.
Excuse me?
They'll never be able to shove them back out the door with the two of us blocking it.
I'm sorry, Tracy. No one said anything about appearing on television. I'm sorry. I simply cannot appear on television at my present weight.
Girl, don't let weight restrict your face. Look at me. I'm on TV.
Oh, but Miss Motormouth, you're a celebrity. Well, I'm a simple housewife of indeterminate girth.
The bigger the girth, the more you're worth.
Mr. Turnblad, you don't mind that the missus here is an ample American, do you?
Hello. I see her as prime real estate.
Yeah, nice and roomy. Listen to me. Once upon a time, girl, I was just like you. Never let my extra large lard just shine through. Big and stout. She said you gotta love yourself
Okay.
Ladies, you've got a visitor, you've posted bail.
Hey!
Thank
Bell for everyone. Bell for the house. You're free to go. Shall we make haste?
Hold it right there, sucker man. We're keeping that rotund rouser on ice.
I pay for everyone. Got a group discount.
Tracy Turnblad is herewith and forewith withheld without bail. She's to be moved to solitary confinement and held there until further notice by special order of the governor's office. So there.
The governor's office? Mrs. Von Tussle, manipulating our judicial system just to win a contest is un-American.
Now don't make things worse for yourselves and move out peacefully.
I'm not leaving here without my daughter.
It's okay, Daddy. They can't keep me here forever. Besides, I've got a lot to think about. I might as well do it in solitary confinement.
I'm counting to three, and I'm re-arresting you for illegal trespass.
Let's go. We're not doing Tracy any good.
Hey!
Touch one hair on my little girl's head, and I'll be back to teach you a whole new meaning of split dance. One day, Wilbur, my time has come and gone. I'm like a half-filled book of green stamps, beyond redemption.
Suddenly I feel so old.
Nonsense, dog. You're a sprite of sleepy. In fact, every time I'm around you, it's like grabbing hold of a giant joint buzzer.
Styles keep a-changing, the world's rearranging, but Edna, your time is to me. Your time is to be.
Your
Tracy! Tracy! It's me, Link Larkin.
From the show?
Link! Over here!
Shh! The guard's asleep. Oh, gee, you look beautiful behind bars.
It must be the low-wide institutional light. Link, what are you doing here?
Oh, Tracy, seeing you get dragged off to jail brought me back to my senses. Thought I lost it when I thought I'd lose you. I couldn't eat, I couldn't sing, I couldn't even concentrate.
You couldn't eat?
No. So I went down to the station to tell Miss Von Tussle that I was through with the Miss Hairspray broadcast.
You did?
I didn't. When I got there, I overheard her talking to Spritzer. Tracy and Amber, the talent scouts, are coming to see. It has nothing to do with me. All this time, I thought Amber and I were a team. Her and her mother were just using me to make her look popular. I feel like such an idiot.
That makes two of us.
I know a palooka like me isn't worthy of a groundbreaking extremist like you. And, well, it's a little scuff from Amber throwing it in my face when I told her I'd rather be, rather be with you.
You did?
I did. Oh, would you consider wearing my ring?
Would I? Would I?
Oh, to lose thee or to lose myself. I don't know, some kid named Milton wrote that. Third floor boys room.
It's beautiful. I have a great life, good parents, my own room, stacks of 45, three sweaters, and even a learner's permit to go through life. But you know what I've been missing, Link?
I think I do. Tracy, they keep us from kissing. They can't stop us from seeing. Once I was a selfish fool and never understood. I never looked inside myself, but on the outside, I look good.
Yeah.
Well, I've got a simple lighter. And, got some hairspray, too.
Oh, Link, what a special night. Your ring and our very own blowtorch.
Tracy, why did you start all this in the first place? Was it so you could dance on TV? Then maybe it was so you could get the boy.
No, I almost lost him because of it.
Then maybe you were just trying to get yourself famous.
No, I just think it's stupid we can't all dance on TV together.
So you tried once and you failed. We can't get crazy and lazy when things get crazy. Children, you were not the first to try and you won't be the last. But I'm here to tell you, I'm gonna keep lining up until someday somebody breaks through. Because I've been looking at that door a lot longer than you.
What door?
The front door.
There's a lot. Light.
got your jailbird daughter in that can, don't you?
Not a chance.
Well, tell you what, if she's in that can, she's gonna rot in that can. Guards, if anybody so much as touches this thing, open fire.
Understood, ma'am.
You're a clever woman, Buzz Hustle. I'll give you that.
Oh, just get out. Corny, back on camera one. 3, 2, 1.
And now for the talent portion of our competition, where the front runner gals present a dance of their own creation. Presently, Amber Von Tussle and Tracy Turnblad are neck in neck. But since, according to the latest police bulletin, Miss Turnblad is still at large, our Miss Hairspray might just be a foregone conclusion. But still, our rule states that our contestants must dance for it. Are you ready, Amber?
Ready as a rabbit.
You can drive and stop.
Would that happen to be me?
Of course, you, Link. But I'd also like to get my degree in musicology with a minor in ethnic studies. And there's something else I'd like to say. The Courtney Collins Show is now and forevermore officially integrated!
Look up, America! Here's history right before your eyes. Television will never be the same!
This is marvelous! Marvelous! The phones are going crazy! The whole country is watching! Even the governor called. He is enjoying the show so much that he granted a pardon to Tracy! Scholarship to Essex Community College. Oh, this is marvelous. You can't buy this kind of publicity. Velma, you are a genius.
Well, yes, I am.
Ultra Clutch is about to launch an entirely new line of products. And I want this woman to head the campaign.
Just don't know what to say.
Well, it comes with offices. Coming up, a multi-figure salary.
Oh, I just don't know what to say.
Oh, Velma Fontessel, you are the newly appointed vice president of Ultra Glow. Beauty products for women of color. And America is ready to hear you two kids sing our new theme song. And I think I can get you a recording contract.
My big break!
I know you got my daughter. I saw it on the TV.
Hey, I hardly recognize you done up like that.
I'm a pretty girl, Mom.
I can't say it's what I want. Fine-looking cat-like Blackmore is responsible for the light in your eyes.
Well, then how could I have been?
By television, there's nothing like it. Tracy, this may not be the right moment since we're on national TV and all. But if I don't kiss you right now, I just may bust a gut.
Well, we wouldn't want you to hurt yourself now, would we?
Myself.